In a world that is digitizing, paper files once told stories of groundbreaking inventions. In line with digital transformation, in late 2022 we started to remove patent files from the archives. But we want to give a second life to some of them, and embarked on a call for artists. More than 260 artists from over 20 different nationalities followed the call. By December 22, 16 had been pre-selected and invited to Munich and The Hague, to get inspired on site from the spaces, the paper files, their inventions and to experience the energy of EPO staff. In a parallel video call between Munich and The Hague, the whole process was outlined and an introduction to patent history was provided, which created a link to the once indispensable paper folders that are no longer required. Some authentic paper folders were handed out to the finalists, to give them an impression of the material they were going to transform into artworks, if their submissions were to be selected. Not long after the meeting, the artists were able to inspect and get a feeling for the space where their proposed artworks were supposed to be exhibited.
It was initially really this reading about something that I had been researching in, and from that getting a thought of working in a completely different material, because I felt like, okay, I won't go the same direction and working with the same material which I have been working so far.
And there are traces of lots of it as well. Like traces of millions and millions of, I don't know how many applications, I think it's in the millions, that the EPO will have received over the years. And you, when you suddenly close your eyes and see all those people in all their offices and garages and factories and laboratories, yeah, there's something kind of poetic and attractive in that way. Yeah.
The plethora of information, of single ideas that get interconnected and depending on the object or the product, that then gets created is that each product is a combination of multiple ideas from multiple historic levels.
Which is really about a transformation, and it's not recycling, it's giving a tribute to the history.
A jury formed by experts from within and outside of the EPO decided about the four winners.
Hopefully we will come with a clear proposal of the winner.
After a thorough process, where the jury was at the same time challenged and touched by the different submissions, which led to some engaging and ultimately fruitful discussions, they were convinced they had made the right choice.
And I hope the final solution obviously will be, you know, taken on in a positive way by, first of all, the members and the staff members here of the European Patent Office, but also, of course, to everyone who gets to see it.
On Monday, the 13th of November, the inauguration took place. The artworks are now exhibited in Munich, Schorhofer and The Hague.
And I have to say that I was particularly impressed by the high number of high-quality proposals that the office has received in this open call for artists.
Jill Delindro is the winner in The Hague with Expanded Theremin, that uses sound as a sculptural tool, using 40,000 rolled sheets of paper from the files.
So a generation of 50 years that worked with paper, they spend a lot of time with the paper, you know, the material, the notes, all that. So when I, as an artist, decide to spend time with it, I'm like actually trying to understand it better. It's not only about making a work that is visually captivating on the online, but it's, I think art is also a way of you interacting and trying to make processes where you learn a bit of how other things have been done.
Irene Sotter created fragment 927. Hundreds of files have been used to create the large sheet of paper, in a silent representation of all technologies.
This was an opportunity for me to create a very visible farewell to the analog and to paper, which has been a very fundamental material of our culture of the last 1,000 years.
Non-Niten created Upload, using 3D print technology to transport the past into the future. The paper files are processed into a paste, then printed into the various sculptures.
As a conceptual artist, I find it important to rethink materials and research new sustainable ways to realize my concept.
Lydia Siegley, in collaboration with Max Planck for Colloids and Interfaces, is the winner in Munich, with her iridescent cellulose nanocrystals extracted from the cellulose of the paper files. The aim is to recreate the nanophotonic architectures that some plants evolved.
What the European Patent Office and Max Planck Institute have in common is that they are at the forefront of emerging technologies.
We are very proud to be able to add these four artworks to the EPO art collection as a remembrance of the recent past. History changes, technology develops, and so does our new ways of working.